Why is it so hard to get a loan in an LLC? What is going on YouTube? It's Matt Fairclough. Thank you for watching this YouTube channel. My name is Matt. My company is called the DeRosa Group, and you can check out more about us at DeRosaGroup.com. That is DeRosaGroup.com, DeRosaGroup.com. Go there and check out all the cool stuff that we're up to, like investing stuff that we're doing, DeRosa Insiders. You guys want to check that out. That's a really, really cool program, low cost access to me personally, access to the rest of my real estate team, and views of a lot of the real estate stuff that we're up to in the world, like hours worth of videos and live sessions with me, so you can pick my brain and talk real estate shop one-on-one on those live sessions. So check out theroastergroup.com for more information on that. Now, Mentorship Monday works like this. People email questions to help me at theroastergroup.com. Please help me at theroastergroup.com, and I'll answer your questions right here on this YouTube channel for you and everybody else to learn from. Today's question comes from Robert. Robert's down in Philly. Actually lives in Jersey, but he works in Philly, and you guys should check out his company, Park Town Homes LLC. Now, Robert's asking about LLCs. So, hey Matt, I saw your LLC video today, which I did shoot a big video on LLCs the other day. You guys should check that out in the channel, in the playlist here. So he says, I think that one thing that really, nobody really seems to talk about, which is my opinion is huge, is financing through an LLC. Traditional banks don't seem to lend the same to an LLC as opposed to a personal investment. You're right, Robert, and we'll talk about that in a second. Some claim you should buy under your personal name, then transfer to an LLC, but are there risks to that? The difference is financing terms can really swing your ROI, sometimes to the point where it's a bad deal. Robert's right. You know, there are, it could be a good deal under traditional financing in your own personal name and a bad deal under LLC financing. For example, 30 year versus 25 year with variable interest rates, meaning like about every 5 years, the rate's going to shift for an LLC loan. To me, it's a much more applicable topic than the, Robert's also pointing out that LLCs give a lot of liability protection, but they also cause, you know, what could be viewed as lower mortgage values, right? Or lower mortgages. Here's a few things on LLCs, okay? Now, my YouTube channel has a ton out there on LLCs, so if you guys want to learn about what LLCs are, why you should have them, there's a ton on this YouTube channel for LLCs, okay? That's not what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about financing from LLCs. Now, one thing you got to remember, Robert, and this is, you didn't think about this in your question on, well, why would I just get into my own name? Fair enough. But if you get a mortgage in your own personal name, even if you get it in your own name and then quit claim, deed it over to the LLC after, unless you refinance that property, unless you, you know, buy it in your own name, move it to an LLC, and then refinance it in the LLC to put an LLC mortgage on it, this is not as good of a mortgage as you're referring to, right? Unless you do that, you're going to have a mortgage in your personal name showing on your credit report. You're only allowed to have 10, okay? And that number may drop. So you're only allowed to have 10 mortgages in your personal name in your, on your credit report before any bank is going to flag you to say, well, you got too many mortgages, right? We've got way more than 10 that we have our LLCs on, but that's because it's the LLC that's the borrower, not your personal name. You will hit a ceiling, number one. That's the first reason why you got to use an LLC, is you will hit a ceiling on how many times your personal name can be on a mortgage as the borrower, right? It's you know, the glass ceiling is 10, and like I said, they're going to drop it down, and you don't want to get to 10 because it's going to lower your credit score through looking at your debt to income ratio, because you're going to have more and more debt in your personal name. That is reason number one on why you can't, if you're going to build a big real estate portfolio, you can't put it all in your personal name, because it'll just end up tearing up your personal credit score to the point where it's just not going to make sense. So yes, Robert. Banks do want to see probably a five-year rate lock and then rate resets every 5 years after. They're going to want to see, it's going to be slightly higher interest rates. That's just the rules of playing the game. In larger properties and in just any investment-grade real estate, that's just the way the rules are, that the rates are going to be locked for about 5 years. Maybe more. Maybe you can negotiate 7 or even 10 for a little bit of a higher interest rate. So that's maybe a little carried out there for you, that maybe you can can negotiate a better deal with the bank. I can't tell you why this happens. It just is what it is. I just think banks tend to view commercial investment grade real estate as a higher risk. If you're building a big business around it, for some reason they view that, they view you buying a rental property in your own personal name differently than an LLC. My guess, here's a few guesses I have. Number one, you could bankrupt that LLC and make it go away, even though you're a personal guarantor, and they could come back and get you because they're going to make you guarantee the mortgage too. Even though that's there, it's harder for them to get to you, right? Versus you just being a direct guarantor with your own name on the mortgage, I guess. That's one thing. I think that the people that that, because obviously the bank's not lending you their money, they're getting money from behind them, from other people, investors of theirs that are investing with them to lend you that money. So I think that their investors view that to be different, an LLC-based loan versus an individual loan. Those are my two guesses, Robert, and on why it's set up that way. But it is what it is. It is a cost of doing business in working in larger real estate. So just, it's something you got to deal with for larger property. So that's my answer. What else? I think I answered your question. So you got to learn to underwrite to those terms. So you're like, well, it makes my deal bad. You're probably right. So you guys should start looking at deals for, as you grow your business, your real estate investing business, look at mortgages that are going to be, you know, 75% loan to value, floating rates that change after 5 years, maybe a 0.5% higher than what they could be that you could get in your own personal name. And you've got to get a little more creative on how you can make deals work. We don't lay 25% down every time we do a deal. We use the BRRRR strategy. We use strategies that are in my book, Raising Private Capital, by bringing investors into our deals. You just got to get more creative, Robert, if you really want to build your business. But we're not laying 25% down every time we do a deal, and you shouldn't factor in doing that either. You got to just get more creative with the way you're putting your deals together. So, more questions on that. If you guys want to email them to me, I'm happy to get into more creative financing stuff, how to raise investors. Whatever you guys want to get into, I will go there for you. No problem here on this YouTube channel because I care and I want to help you. So help me at derosagroup.com with your mentorship Monday questions, and I'll answer them right here. That's what I got for you. Thank you, Robert. Make sure to check Robert out at Park Town Homes LLC to hear more about him. I appreciate you guys. Have a great and profitable week.